Sicilian defense, Taimanov, Bastrykov variation, 6.b3 is 6-7.b2 nf6-8.00bb49.na400. Balanced, neither player ever had an advantage. That game was pretty competitive. Both players had an amazing opening. That was a well-fought middle game that Black got the better of. Sharp games are frequently the result of starting with the king's pawn, since it dominates the center and frees up the bishop and queen on the light squares. The c-pawn in the Sicilian defense controls the d4 square. Nf3 moves the knight toward the center in anticipation of a pawn push on d4, where it will be ready to retake the piece if Black captures on d4. The dark-squared bishop has a fresh opening created by e6, and the queen has a new diagonal created by e6. d4 offers to trade the more important central d4 pawn for the c5 pawn in exchange for more control of the center and quick development. Cxd4 gives Black two central pawns versus one central pawn for White. Nxd4 recaptures the pawn and activates the knight in return for having one central pawn versus Black's two central pawns. Nc6 challenges the knight on d4 and controls the e5 square. Nc3 defends the e4 pawn and puts more pressure on the d5 square. Qc7 defends the knight on c6 and controls the important d6 and e5 squares. b2 develops the bishop and prepares castling. a6 prepares the b5 pawn push and stops the white pieces from coming to b5. b3 develops the bishop toward the center and protects the knight on d4. nf6 develops the knight toward the center, controls the d5 square and attacks the e4 pawn. Castling gets the king out of the center and activates the rook. bb4 develops the bishop, attacks the knight that is guarding e4 and prepares to castle. Na4 prevents the black bishop from capturing on c3 and targets the queenside dark squares. Castling gets the king to a safer square, out of the center of the board, while also developing a rook. Castling to the same side of the board as the opponent avoids some of the attacking associated with opposite side castling. This is an equal trade. Backs off. This attacks a rook, winning a tempo when it moves away. This activates a piece and simultaneously wins time by attacking an opposing knight. Recaptures. This makes a passed pawn, meaning no opposing pawn can challenge it on its way to promotion. This is the only move that works. This move puts the rook on a safer square. This threatens to reveal an attack on a pawn. A pawn that was being attacked and had no defenses is now protected by this. This exposes an attack, threatening a pawn. This blocks an attack on a vulnerable pawn. This threatens to fork pieces. This strikes at the center, countering the opponent's ability to grab space. This is the only good move. It is the last book move. This ignores a better way to move a piece to safety. This allows the opponent to activate a rook by getting it to the 7th rank. It is an inaccuracy. It was a free pawn there. It is ideal. This poses a threat to strike a knight. That's good. This is not the best. It is an inaccuracy. This strikes a rival knight. That's good. This offers to exchange pieces of equal value. It is best. It is a fair deal after all captures. It is ideal. Backs off. It is ideal. This avoids the queen's check. It is ideal. The knight is thus brought to safety. It is ideal. This ignores an opportunity to develop a piece while also winning a tempo on a rook. It is an inaccuracy. This ignores an opportunity to threaten winning a queen. This permits the opponent to push a passed pawn towards promotion. It is a mistake. This misses an opportunity to push a passed pawn towards promotion. It is a misbalanced, neither player ever had an advantage. That game was pretty competitive. Both players had an amazing opening. That was a well-fought middle game that Black got the better of.